Save. Hello, this is Professor Rios. Welcome to Electrica Level 3. We actually finished the class, so we're going to start covering other material from Electrica Level 3. I wish I could get rid of this. Okay, that's it. Anyways, let's continue without any further delays. Now, in order to change the slide, I have to, my God, every time go to the program, then go here and go like this.
Good morning, Professor. Sorry for the late start.
Hello?
Good morning, Professor. I'm sorry for the late start.
Oh, that's okay. I'm glad that you're here. What happened?
I had trouble connecting. It was when I clicked connect, it said this room is not in progress. But I got it anyway.
Well, we were back and forth from the other meeting to this one. We were having problems with that one, so.
Okay, that sounds good. I'm glad I'm here.
Okay. So I can change my size and my location. Okay. So all I have to do is to go like this. Okay. Anyways, what is the objective of this module? One, the objective of this module, I like this. The objective of this module is to teach you how to calculate branch circuit loads, okay? And branch circuit loads, in order to do that, you need to calculate the branch circuit rating. You need to also apply the rating factors, and you need to calculate branch circuit ampacity. What is the ampacity, Jacob? Do you remember that?
The ampacity in which circuit, in a specific circuit, or it's the amount of amps it's able to withstand.
Okay. All right.
Of current, constant current use.
Okay, Ezequiel, what do you have to say about that?
Yeah, I think it's pretty much just what Jacob said.
Okay, it's
that's what I agree with at least.
Okay. And Halani, what do you have to say about that? Hello, Halani. See you coming in.
Hello.
How are you? Do you have your coffee today?
Huh?
Do you have your coffee today?
Yeah, my bad. I want to go do the thing with the panel for the question.
Okay.
My power. But, yeah, I think what they think.
Okay. What about Mr. Wilson?
Yes, Professor. Yeah, I think it's the same thing Jacob said. It's
okay.
It's that one.
You guys can work as a team in any company. Well, it's awesome. Okay. Ampacity is the current, the maximum current a wire can take or can allowed to pass at a given temperature, okay? Because there are more wires or there is a higher temperature. So in order to keep the temperature low, you have a maximum current that it allows you to, you know, you will It's not that it will stop the current, because you can put you have the capacity to have more current. But in order to keep the temperature low, or at the maximum temperature that the wire can take, you have to reduce the current. Because in the case, for example, that you have three or more wires in a conduit, heat starts building up, okay? And the conduit acts as a heat sink. But the heat generates faster than it can be dissipated. So you have to reduce the current to keep temperature at bay. The important thing is that I don't want you guys to memorize something and just, you know, say it. Think about the concept, okay? Think about what actually really means. Is that clear? Guys? Okay.
Yes, professor. It's okay.
Yep.
Okay. So let's go to the next slide. And let's see. Where do I press now? My God. Here. Let's see. What is the basic purpose of branch circuit load calculation? Okay. Basically, is to determine the size of the branch circuit over current protection and branch circuit conductors using the National Electrical Code requirements. Jacob, can you tell me that in different words, in your own words?
So the branch circuit is has been designed from the ground up, basically with an average current load designed with its use. So basically, each circuit will not overload the ampacity that it's been designed to function at. Maybe I'm wrong. I don't know.
No, what we're talking about is like when we do the power calculation of a house.
Oh, you're saying
yeah, it's different. You see that it's different?
Yeah, so overcurrent protection. Yeah. So
what
should be rated at like 125% of its load.
Okay, let me ask you a question. What is overcurrent protection?
If some circuit in the house or anywhere for that matter runs over the allotted amount of current, the wire will begin to heat up, and so there's a fail-safe in that shuts it off.
Not quite.
No?
Let me ask you, specifically, when remember that chapter, overcurrent protection and wiring, what chapter was that of the National Electrical Code?
Oof, right on the spot, Professor. I'm not sure.
Chapter one was what? Let's go through that. Chapter one or zero was information, right? General information, 90 actually.
Right.
So it was definition of, you know, what is an NEC all about?
Right.
One is what? It's like a dictionary, it's definitions.
Right.
Okay. Two is wiring and
methods, right?
No, wiring and
protection.
Yes, exactly.
Right.
Which is basically the size of the wires and the breakers. So overcurrent protection is the breakers. The breakers is what, you know, once you reach that 20 amps, it will trip. Okay. So what is telling me here to determine the size of a brand secret over current protection and brand secret conductors is like you determine what the need is, you determine what is the size of the conductor that you need, okay? And then you use the overcurrent protection to make sure the conductors will not take more current than it can take because they will burn. That's what overcurrent protection is. Is that clear to everyone?
Yep.
Wilson?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
So that's basically what brand secret load calculations is all about, okay? Let's take a look at this other question. What is what you need to identify? Let's say you need to identify three situations where the ampacity of conductor must be derated, okay? What means that the ampacity has to be derated? Wake up.
Try to answer the question. It's somebody else's turn.
Well, okay. What is the... Okay.
It's okay. Maybe they'd be. I think they'd be.
Identify at least, no, this is not a multiple choice question, okay? Identify which situations you need to start, you know, applying the rating factor to a wire. And here are the answers. The rule is if you have more than three wires in a conductor, you need to start applying the rating factor. What is the rating factor? Reduce the current by a percentage. Okay. Ambient temperature.
So how you read the percentage, the current by percentage? How you do it now?
We are going to do problems from Michael Holt. Okay, Mike Holt, in reference to this. Okay. And after we're done with the presentation, we're going to get into that. So you actually see actual problems that you use with these rules. So if the ambient temperature surrounding the conductor exceeds the temperature rating of the conductor, why? Because if the conductors, you know, takes, let's say 100 degrees Fahrenheit, right? And you place the conductor in an environment that is 100 degrees already, that's not a very good example because if the maximum rate of temperature of a conductor is 100 degrees and you place a conductor there, it's about to break, okay? It's about to melt. So that's a bad example. Let's say the maximum degrees is 100, right? And the conductor can take up to 80, let's say. So you don't want the wire go over 80, okay? And since the conductor will heat up, okay, chances are it's going to go over even 100. So what you need to do is to reduce the current, okay, so that the maximum temperature will never go over 100. Is that clear, or it was kind of confusing? Hello?
Sounds good, Professor.
So tell me about this ambient temperature surrounding conductor exceeds temperature rating of the conductor. What is this all about?
Well, when you have the ambient temperature of the wire is when there's no current, and then when current is going through, you need to have it below a certain temperature to be up to code, and then I suppose if you need more than the current already carrying the wire, you need to upgrade to a larger wire, a lower gauge.
Well, now that I'm looking at this, I think this is totally wrong. I have to give him a call.
All right, tell us why.
Let me tell you why. If the maximum rating of this wire is 100 degrees, okay, means that over 100 degrees, this will melt. Is that clear?
Right.
Okay. And he's telling me, ambient temperature surrounding the conductor exceeds the temperature rating for the conductor. Now, if this conductor is 100 degrees and the ambient temperature is 120 degrees, what is going to happen to the temperature of the conductor with no current whatsoever?
Should increase.
120. So with no current at all, it's already over the rating of the conductor. You see the difference? So this is wrong. I will make a note and how do I make a note? Unless I take a picture of this. So I never know what the light is. I will write him an email. Now, what is another condition? Voltage drop from excessive conductor length is 3% for branch circuits, or 5% for feeder and branch circuit combination. Why is that? Because you have a wire, okay? You have a piece of wire. The voltage drop between point A and point B is more than 3%. So even if the wire can take more current, what happens if you increase the current? That percentage is going to increase or decrease?
Decrease, right?
Okay, let's sip
some
coffee and I'll ask you again. Guillermo. Mr. Guillermo, we're waiting for you in the class. Can you hear me? Guillermo? What happened here? Again. Mr. Guillermo, we're waiting for you. We're waiting for you in the class.
Estoy tratando de entrar hace rato. No sé por qué no me he querido entrar, pero ya yo dentro de un ratito entro. Estoy buscando la forma de entrar.
No entres al otro que yo puse allí de Big Blue Bottom. Olvídate de eso. Entra a Webex, porque estuvimos allí, aquello empezó a hacer flashes y tal. Y nada, volvimos a Webex. Ya yo le explicaré al día.
Lo que pasa es que no sé por qué no me ha querido entrar.
¿Estás en Webex?
Pero ya yo... Sí, o sea, estoy tratando de entrar, pero...
Mira, atiende una cosa. Atiende una cosa. Si tratas de entrar a Big Blue Button, apaga el ordenador.
¿Cómo?
Apaga el ordenador, enciéndelo. Haces el login...
Ah,
ok. Haces el login en Canvas, vas al link para entrar a Webex,
ajá,
que está en mi,
sí,
en mi página, y ahí ya entras.
Ajá, sí.
Okay.
Ok, pues yo lo voy a apagar, lo voy a encender de nuevo. Que
vale,
por esto,
no, nos vemos allí. Hasta luego.
Porque yo la dejé encendida, la computadora, yo no la apago.
Vale, chao.
Sí, pues está bien, ok.
Oh, my God. Do you know the danger when you leave the computer on? He told me, and he never turned off the computer. That you may forget your password to get back in. Okay, we were talking about the voltage drop, right? If I have a voltage drop here of, let's say, 2 volts, okay, with 10 amps, what happens if the current goes from 10 amps to 15 amps? No, let's say to 20 amp, to 20 amp, it will increase, right?
Is that yes, it's increase.
It will increase.
Yeah. Yes.
And the reason why you want to apply the rating factor, because there are rules from the NEC that tells you the voltage drop cannot be more than so much percent. Okay? And you want to keep that legal, per se. Is that clear?
You got it, Professor.
Now, another issue is the cable assembled bundle more than 24 inches in length, okay? If you have cable assembled bundle more than 24 inches in length, you have to apply the rating factors. And that's according to NEC. So let me see if I can become proficient on this. So do this real quick. Go back in here, go back in there. Load calculations. Brand circuit load calculations is what? When you determine the load. It basically to determine the size of the branch circuit or current protection and conductor using the National Electrical Code. Okay, we saw that earlier. Now, what are the applicable codes that we need to become familiar with and use to do this? It's basically Article 210 that covers branch circuits, okay, not for motors. Article 220 covers branch circuit feeder and service loads. 240, and you can find all this here in the book that you have, okay? I want you guys to pick your book and become familiar with those. Let's say 240. 240. What is right here? Overcurrent protection, okay? Overcurrent protection. Can you see? You cannot read, right?
No, I can't see anything. It's just the group chat.
Excuse me?
I can't see a PowerPoint. It's just like the chat.
What about the rest?
What'd you say?
Halani?
I can see the PowerPoint.
You're looking at the PowerPoint?
Yeah, I see the PowerPoint behind you.
Let's see what issue he's having that he sees the... I think you probably have maximized the list of participants. Try to minimize that, Halani. Did it work? Hello? Alan, are you there? Alani? Okay. Let's continue. He just told me he cannot see the PowerPoint, but you guys can see it. So Article 240 is selecting and installing overcurrent protection devices. What are overcurrent protection devices? Can tell me what are overcurrent protection devices?
Breakers.
Something that protects for like oversurge in like current or something.
The right? Breakers. The breakers. Halani, you continue without seeing the PowerPoint?
Yeah, I still can't see a PowerPoint.
Minimize the screen that you have there, please. You probably have maximized the list of participants.
How do I do that?
In the corner of the Windows. You see? Is this what you see? My name, Ezekiel, Jacob, yeah. Nani, and Wilson?
Yeah.
Is that what you see? Click on the X to the right of participants.
To the right of participants.
It says participant 5, there is a space, and then there is an X. That's how you close that window. And tell me what you see.
I don't see what you're talking about.
Are you in the list of participants?
Yes. It's like I see a recording.
Oh, okay.
That's all I see, though. I don't see nothing else.
Oh, you don't see the name of the participants? You don't see the name of the people who are...
I see guys' names, but there's nothing to the right of it on my screen.
Okay. So what you're looking at is... Hold on a second. Telephone is off. Tell me, Alan, is this what you're looking at?
I can't see anything on your screen either.
Oh, you cannot see the camera, of course. Well, I'm going to send this to you by the chat, okay? Tell me, is this what you're looking at? Is that what you're looking at?
Can't see anything.
In your WhatsApp?
Yeah, but mine looks different than yours.
Let me ask you, are you in a smartphone by any chance?
No, I'm on my computer, but I have Apple.
Oh. Okay.
I don't know.
Before you were able to see the PowerPoint, correct?
Yeah. Okay. Hold on, I'll try coming back.
No, let me ask you something. You see what it says, participant 5? Alani? I think he says he was going somewhere and come back, right? Okay, let's go on with that. So, we're talking about the different articles that are for... No, it's better. We're talking about the different articles that are related to the branch circuits, okay? You see that 3 of them are in the 200 range, and 2 of them are in the 400 range, okay? What is the 400 articles, if you remember? What was that all about? The 400 articles. This is something that you need to become proficient with to know where to find what, because that's exactly what you'll be doing in the Yoneman test, okay?
Wait time, Professor, it's 10:20.
Oh, thank you so much for reminding me of that, otherwise I'd be until 10 p.m.
Yeah. Thank you, you're welcome, yeah, wait time.
Enjoy your 10 minutes. Okay, if you want to go outside your home and take a walk around, make sure you wear one of these. Okay, and watch the neighbor that are sneezing on top of you. You go.
I got you.
Take it easy. 10 minutes. 10 minutes. Oh, my God. All those jokes, I'll ask some jokes, wearing all that paint. Logitech. Speakers. Hello, this is Professor Rios again. Welcome back from the break. Let's take a look at this new slide and to make sure you get this about the brand circuit rating, okay? Rating. What is rating? Brand circuit rating. To determine the maximum load served by a single phase branch circuit, this is what you need to do. You multiply the setting of the overcurrent protection device, the circuit breaker, okay, by the voltage. When you multiply current by the voltage, what do you get? Watts. So in this example, you have if the maximum load supply is 20 amps over a two-wire circuit with 120 volts, what is the rating? Is that how much power can be delivered from this branch circuit? And it's 2400 watts, okay, or volt amp. Is that clear? That's how you determine the rating of that, okay? So that means that you should not use this. That's the maximum I can take. It doesn't mean that all the outlets in your house, for example, can take the maximum current, because statistically, it's not like that. If you design a house like that, the wiring will be a lot thicker than they actually are. Okay. So let's continue with this. And let's see what the next slide can tell us. Okay. Now, the rating factor. To the rate current carrying capacity, okay, of a branch circuit conductors, if, what does it mean of this? That you need to apply the rating factors under conditions like the ones we're going to talk about now. If you have more than three current carrying conductors in a raceway, in a situation like that, you have to apply the rating factor. If the ambient temperature exceeds the conductor temperature, actually, we went through this slide before. Or is the voltage drop at 63% or 5% for a feeder and branch circuit combined? So this should be very clear to you right now. What do we have here? How to determine the branch circuit ampacity? To determine the branch circuit ampacity for a single phase circuit, this is what you need to do. You divide the volt amps by the circuit voltage, okay? The ampacity of 120 volts for load. This means one phase, okay? Low rated at 1600 watts is what? 13 amps. This is basically apply the formula that you know of, They're just throwing new words to this, okay? We did that one. This one. What is the maximum continuous load that might be connected to a 20 amp 120 volt fuse? What is the maximum continuous load that might be connected to a 20 amp 120 volt fuse? Okay. Why is that? What do you think it is? If we go and read section 2.10.20, okay, it will tell us that we can use the 20 amp as a continuous load. It has to be 0.8 of that maximum, okay? And I want you guys to try to find this in the NEC, okay? 2.10.20. Look it up because I'm gonna ask you to read, okay? I can see your book, but I can hear your voice. 2.10.20. 2.10.20. Okay. Over current protection. Branch circuit conductors and equipment shall be protected by overcurrent protective devices that has a rating or setting that complies with 2.10.20A through I through D, okay? Letters A through D. And let's see what it says. Where a branch circuit supplies continuous load, which is our case, the rating of overcurrent device shall be no less than the continuous load plus 125% of the continuous load. Okay? What is the meaning of this? Let's read this again. Where the branch circuit supplies continuous loads or any combination of continuous and non-continuous loads, the rating, okay, of the overcurrent device, rating of the overcurrent device, shall not be less than the non-continuous load plus 125% of the load, okay? So 125%, what is the meaning of this? That the breaker should be able to take 125% more than the continuous load. And that's the 16 amps, okay? And like that, you will see, because you have to be careful with this, what is the maximum continuous load that can be connected, okay? In this case, it's talking about a continuous load. So you apply that one. What is the exception to this? Where the assembly, including the overcurrent devices protecting the branch circuit, is listed for operation at 100% of its rating, the ampere rating of the overcurrent device shall be permitted and shall not be less than the sum of the continuous load plus the continuous load. In other words, if the breaker, okay, is rated for usage at that maximum at that maximum load continuously, then you can use it. But it's not usually the case. By the time you reach 20, it will trigger the breaker. Okay? So this is the exercise that you guys need to do. Whenever you see something like this, go to the NEC, actually read it, and there is no earthquake, okay? And practice. Remember, practice makes perfect. Now, let's take a look at the next slide. The next slide is as follows. The voltage drop for a 208 volt one phase circuit, this is what means one phase, okay, not 10, one phase, with a load of 28 amps using number 8 stranded copper conductors at a circuit length of 160 feet is what? Voltage drop, okay? So the voltage drop is what? The voltage drop is equal twice the length times the resistance, okay? This basically, it gives you is resistance times voltage. Resistance times voltage is what? And divided by 1,000 is what? Voltage drop, okay? And why is this? Because in order for this to be volt, you need to use everything in the same volt, resistance, and ohms, right? In order to be volt. But if you're using a different unit, you have to compensate by multiplying or dividing for 1,000. So in this case, this particular case, you have 208 volts, one single phase circuit, and a load of 28 amps using number 8 stranded copper conductors at the circuit length of 160. Okay? Remember, you have a wire that goes, you have line, and then you have neutral, twice the distance. Okay? So because in one wire you have a voltage drop of 2 volts, in the other wire you will also have the voltage drop of 2 volts. Why? Because remember, in any connection you're going to have the line that will reach to the circuit breaker, and you have the neutral that will return the power back to the circuit breaker. So the line will have a voltage drop, and the neutral will have the same voltage drop because the current is supposed to be the same. Therefore, you have to add those two length. Why? Because you measure the voltage drop at this end, okay? At this end. So if these have 2 volts, and this one has 2 volts, here you have 4 volts, okay? That's why you need to multiply this by 2. Is that clear, guys? Every once in a while, I wanna hear some noise because I have a feeling that I'm talking about myself, okay?
Yeah.
In class, at least I can see you. I can see you with the phone.
I think everybody here, they just listen to you.
Okay, so is that clear? How do you do that? Basically, you do twice the length, okay, times the resistance, times the current, and divide it by 1,000. In this case, it's 2 times 160, which is the length, times 0.7078, that's the conductor resistance per pit. Okay. And that's according to NEC table. Okay. And then you multiply that by the amps. So you get, you divide all that by 1,000 and you get 6.97 volts. Let's take a look at that chapter 9 table. Okay. And I will let you guys to do the same thing, because remember, learning a skill is developing connections in your brain. Okay. And the more you practice something, the stronger those connections are, to the point that when you're going to do something, you don't even think about it, you just do it. Okay. That's the point that you need to get at that point while solving all these problems. When you look at it, oh, okay, I know. You know, so you don't have to be to think about it. You are rewarded for that already. Have you noticed that sometimes you're driving, you're going somewhere, you're like, oh my God, I didn't mean to go to that place. I was going somewhere else. Because normally when you drive, you go to that place, right? Because our brain is wired like that. So let's take a look at this NEC chapter 9, table 8, okay? So chapter 9 is where? At the very end. Or at the very beginning, Mr. Wilson? Chapter 8?
Yes, Professor.
Chapter 8?
Yeah, chapter 8?
No, chapter 9, table 8. Table 9, table 8. Table 8. Okay. So, according to this, number 8 is stranded coupled. So what you need to look for here is the number 8, the size of the wire, and stranded. Okay. So you go to copper stranded number 8.
You are an NEC book? Oh, electrical level 2.
Mr. Wilson, we're doing the National Electrical Code. We're looking in chapter 9, table 8. Okay?
Okay. What page?
No, that's what you need to look for. When you are taking the journeyman test, you go, Professor Rios, can you please tell me what page is chapter 9, table 8?
I'll try.
I don't think they're gonna let you. Okay, let's see. Table eight. We're looking for, what are we looking for? Number 8, stranded copper conductor, okay? Number 8, stranded copper conductor. Stranded copper conductor, okay? And we see that the ohms are 0.778. Okay? Did you find it? So that 0.778 is what? Is ohms per 1,000 feet of wire. That's why if that's resistance per 1,000 feet of wire, that's why you have to divide by 1,000 to get the resistance per feet, because you have feet in your calculation. Is that clear? Is that clear to everyone? Let me ask you.
Yeah.
How many of you, and I trust you guys, okay? How many of you actually picked up the book and looked for this?
The book's in my truck. I'm not going to lie, Professor.
Okay, thank you. Mr. Wilson? Mr. Wilson?
Yes, Professor.
Did you look it up?
You see my book?
Did you look it up in your book?
Is that that book?
Did you look it up in the National Ethical Code book?
That's what I'm looking for.
Oh, congratulations.
You see?
Mr. Vergara?
What was the section again?
It says here, chapter 9.
I can't see it on there.
Table 8. Oh, really?
It's not,
so it's really not clear.
Yeah, when it's on your webcam, it's blurry for me.
Okay.
That's what I'm trying to say.
What can you see the letters? I mean, number no. the voltage. You cannot read that?
I can read like 5.87 volts, 5.9 okay. volts, but I can't see the NEC chapter.
Okay, because I think I can change the resolution between like high quality, low quality. Hold on. Let's see what that is. Camera. What was that? I think it's... Speaker, camera, ABS. No, it has to be this one. Okay, I will look into that to make sure we we get a better quality.
I can't hear you talking, Professor.
You can't hear me talking? Hello? You cannot hear me?
Yeah, Professor, you muted your mic.
My mic? Hold on. Hello, hello, hello?
You're talking on the webcam, but I can't hear you.
Hello, hello?
There we go.
I can hear you now.
Oh, okay. When I have the setup up, I won't see the mic. I guess it's not working. Who has a camera? None of you have a camera?
I don't.
Oh, ahí llegó.
¿Cómo está? Ahora fue que pude conectarme.
Pero por favor.
Ahora fue que pude conectarme.
Please, Mr. Guillermo, please. How can you be dressing up like that? I know you're in your home, but you cannot be like. Let me tell you, that is like going to the class.
La computadora me está.
Can you hear me?
Sí. Sí, la computadora me estaba dando problemas.
El problema es el inglés. ¿Tú me estás?
Sí, sí, no, yo sé.
No salgas en camiseta ahí porque te está viendo todo FTC.
Voy a poner camiseta.
A lo mejor una secretaria me manda un email y me dice, mira, el cantante ese que salió haciendo así en camiseta, ¿me puede dar el teléfono, por favor? Que quiero conversar con él.
Ahora mismo,
póngase una camisa, por favor, señores, que esto es una cosa seria con el Departamento de Educación, hombre.
Un momentico.
Tú por lo menos tienes camiseta, puede que alguno salga sin camisa, ¿no? Porque yo ahora es. Come on. Okay, guys. What is the presentation? Nuggets. No, las Nuggets. Aquí está. So, is it clear how we calculate the voltage drop? This is so easy. Okay. A ver, Guillermo, a ver, a ver, a ver la camisa esa. Así, 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 ¿cómo es? Por favor, yo la corbata la mandé a lavar. Ok. Entonces, welcome to the class, Guillermo. Welcome to the class. I'm glad you're here. So we're going to continue with this. Okay. So it's clear how to do the voltage drop, right? Voltage drop is number one, you have to multiply by two. Number two, you have to multiply by the length. Number three, you have to multiply by the resistance of the wire that you will find in the NEC chapter 9 table 8 in kilo ohms. No, that in ohms times 1,000 feet of wire. Okay, that's those ohms is per 1,000 feet of wire. And then you have to divide that by 1,000. So this is 10, you know, by 1,000 feet of wire, so you get it by feet. Okay? And that will give you the resistance, not the resistance, the voltage drop, total voltage drop. Is that clear to everyone?
Yep.
Vergara, can you say, okay, I'm covering the formulas here. Can you say what I just said in your own words? How do you calculate the voltage drop of this problem?
By multiplying by a factor of two, and then by the length of the
of the circuit.
Yeah, length of the circuit.
Okay. And then.
That's what I remember.
And you divide by 1,000?
No, you have to multiply by the resistance of the wire.
Okay.
Because if you take a look, all you're doing here is applying Ohm's law, okay? This gives you resistance, okay? This gives you resistance and current, right? Resistance times current give you what? Voltage. That's Ohm's law. Okay? So basically, all you have to remember is that you don't even have to remember that. You can't even deduct this. The voltage drop is always two because it's two wires times the length, okay? Times the resistance per 1,000 feet. You divide by 1,000, so you get the resistance per feet. And that will give you the voltage. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Who was that? Who was John in there? Okay, guys. Let's go to the next slide. As you can see, this is the type of problem that you only have to see it once and understand it, and you know forever how to do it because it's common sense. Okay. The problem is, when you have never seen a problem like this, and they give you like that in the journeyman test, you're like, oh my God, how do you do this? The moment you do something like that, you are lost. We have to do this so many times. By the time you look at it, like, oh yeah, I know. It's twice the distance times the resistance that I find in the table of the NEC. I divide it by 1,000 because the resistance is per 1,000, you know. Once you look at it, you have to act on it. There is no time to start thinking about it. Okay? So, the next one is what? What is the opacity of? Did we do that one earlier? Of
yeah, the ability to carry current.
Okay, 120 volt, one phase at 200 volt amp. Okay, it's basically to calculate the current with ohms, with the, you know, the formula that you know. Okay, the next section is residential branch circuit requirements. Okay, so I'm going to upload the next PowerPoint presentation, which is this one here. One, two, three, and four. That one. Okay. And it's funny when I thought, like, how come it looks like I'm behind that equipment to fix it or something? My God. Anyways. So, going back to the slide, we're going to continue with our calculation of branch, residential branch circuit, okay? So now, what is the objective of this, okay, that lesson? By the time you complete that, you should be able to do the following. Calculate igniting loads, calculate the receptacle loads, calculate small appliance loads, calculate laundry circuit loads, calculate cooking appliance loads, calculate water heater loads, electric heating loads, and calculate air conditioner loads. Do you remember that Excel file where you would have to put the numbers and find some items in the National Electrical Code, and you complete the whole calculation of the house? This is exactly what this is, okay? Now, the next slide is this one. What is the most important piece of information needed to size the circuit for residential cooking? Okay, for the kitchen. The nameplate. In the nameplate, you have the voltage requirement, current requirement, you know, all the information in terms of consumption, and that electrically defined this unit is in the nameplate, okay? If you keep that in mind, there is no way that you can go wrong. What is the next one? Oh, that's what I'm gonna do. Why must the branch circuit supplying an 80-gallon water heater be rated at no less than 125% of the heater's nameplate rating? Let's see. Why the branch circuit supplying an 80-gallon water heater have to be rated no less than 125%? Of the heater's nameplate rating. Remember about the branch circuit before, 125%? Because the water heater is considered to be a continuous load, okay? What is the exception of this rule? If the breaker that you have Taking that branch circuit tells you that at the maximum power can be used in a continuous basis, then you can do it. Okay? Is that clear? Let's see the next. What are the lighting loads? Okay. Lighting load branch circuit calculations are based on what? Number one, the type of lighting. Number two, the branch circuit voltage. And number three, whether or not the lighting is continuous duty or not. Okay, let's go back. Type of lighting, it can be incandescent, electrical discharge. They're the ones that that give the brightest light. Branch circuit voltage, and whether or not the lighting is continuous duty. The load for recessed lighting fixtures is calculated by using the maximum volt amp rating in the fixture of the lamp. Okay. I think this is the second time I use this being in the middle of the PowerPoint. I like that. Now let's take a look at the next slide. And let's talk about receptacle loads. When the exact volt amp rating of the load being plugged into the receptacle is not known, okay, a rating of no less than 180 watts per outlet is used. When the exact VA rating of a load, that's the regular receptacles, okay, being plugged into a receptacle. Am I recording this thing? Yes. You need to use 180 watts, okay? For continuous loads, the total load is calculated at 100%. For non-continuous loads, the total is calculated at 100%. And for continuous load, the total load is calculated at 125%. Okay? Is that clear? Now, without the slide. Okay, the receptacles. How are the receptacles calculated? For non-continuous load, whatever power it is. For continuous load, you have to be... What does it mean that it's calculated at 125 of the maximum load? It means that the continuous load, okay, should not reach the 100% capacity of the outlet, okay? This is basically for you to understand this. When we do the mic hold exercise, you will notice that it's a lot, makes a lot of sense, a lot more of sense. Now, appliance loads. The appliance loads. The small appliance, what are the small appliance load? What do you think is small appliance load? A small appliance circuit. Wilson, what do you think? Say it again.
I think there are things like microwaves, thunders, I think maybe.
Toaster, yeah, all those appliances like that you use. Mm-hmm. Okay. Very good. the NEC requirements for small appliance branch circuits are. Now, what is a branch circuit? Alani, what is a branch circuit? Mr. Alani? Oh. What is a branch circuit?
It branches off into more circuits, right?
A branch, well, you can say a tree that opens to different places, no? But what is a branch circuit?
Tell me.
Okay. Vergara? A branch circuit.
A circuit that comes from the panel and gives power to multiple things.
Exactly. Alani, keep that in mind, okay?
I just said.
No, I understood. It's something that branches something. That's what I understood.
Branches off into other circuits. But I didn't say the part about the panel.
No, a branch circuit doesn't branch off to other circuits. The branch circuit is the wiring that comes from the main panel to the first outlet. It doesn't branch anywhere else. This is it. Okay? It goes from point A.
The other outlet getting power from that outlet?
But you are... Okay. When you are talking to define something, you have to talk about that. No, what is not. Okay? The cable that goes from outlet to outlet, it is not a branch circuit. It's the cable that goes from the first outlet to the breaker. That's the branch circuit. Okay, we got it? Is that clear? When I talk to you guys about something like this, I want you to visualize the wires, okay? It's the wire that goes to the breaker, you know, through the conduits, all that, down to the first outlet. And then those other wires, that has another name. Okay? Now that we know what an appliance load is and what a branch circuit is, let's see how you determine this load. You must have at least 220 amp circuits in the kitchen, pantry, breakfast room, and dining room receptacles. Okay, so in each of these places, at the very least, you should have two circuits. What is the meaning of this? Can anybody explain to me what is the meaning of this? At least 220 circuits to supply kitchen, pantry, breakfast room, and dining room, etc. What is the meaning of that? Does it mean that I need to have at least two outlets in the kitchen and two outlets in the pantry and two outlets in the breakfast room and two outlets in the dining room? Is that what it means or not?
Yeah.
Who said yes?
Hi, Professor. Yes. I have to go.
Okay.
And I have to do something for the family.
It was a pleasure having you in my virtual class. Can I safely cover your nose, cover your mouth, and you know, I'll see you tomorrow. Not tomorrow, but
Monday.
On Monday at the same time.
All right, okay? Professor. Thank you. Bye, guys.
Take it easy. What happened? Hello?
Hello, hello, hello.
Okay, what happened here? What did I click on? Can you apriete aquí? A ver, si lo río. Esto es. Para, okay, ya estamos aquí. Vamos a ver. Guillermo, trata de explicarme a ver qué significa eso.
El plan circo.
¿Qué cosa es? Que el requerimiento del Código Nacional de Electricidad para el Monarch Appliance Circuit, ¿ok? Para el Appliance Circuit, requiere por lo menos dos circuitos de 20 amperios para la cocina, el pantry, breakfast room, dining room, receptacle. ¿Qué quiere decir eso? Que tengo dos outlets en la cocina. ¿Qué es eso? Explícamelo.
Bueno, si lo que requiere es, o sea, que los circuitos de 20 amperios es para que se distribuya, en, por ejemplo, en la cocina, en los diferentes conectores que se vayan a poner. Que, o sea, que si se van a poner, vamos a suponerlo así.
Dame un ejemplo de una cocina que tiene dos de esos de 20 amperios. A ver, ¿qué es eso? ¿Para qué es?
Bueno, van a estar divididos. Todo lo que está en la cocina va a estar dividido en 20 y 20. O sea, una parte va a coger 20 amperes y la otra 20 amperes.
Correcto, correcto.
Sí, va a haber una división.
Ok, Ezequiel. Can you please explain that to me? What is the meaning of that? At least 220 amp circuit to supply kitchen, pantry, breakfast room, and dining room receptacles?
Exactly what it says. You at least NSC is always a minimum requirement, so it says at least,
but it's not
220 amp circuits to supply power to kitchen, pantry, breakfast room, dining room, the outlet.
So I can have more than two outlets, right?
Yep.
So basically, they have two breakers of 20 amps. And each of those breakers.
It's just stating the minimum requirement.
The minimum requirement.
So if you want, you can have more than two, but then later, you're probably going to have to make some modifications to the amount of power you're getting.
But describe me one of these 20 amp circuits. Describe me one of them. How will you use one of those circuits for this small appliance load? In the kitchen, for example, how will you use one of those circuits of 20 amps in the kitchen?
With the microwave?
My question is, does it mean that I can have more than, for one of these 20 amp circuit, I can have more than one outlet in the kitchen?
It's stating that you need two 20 amp circuits. So I would assume that you would need at least two outlets.
But can you connect two outlets to one of these of 20 amp circuits?
Yes.
Okay. I wanted to make sure that it's understood that it's making reference, and that's why I asked, if you know what a branch circuit is. This makes reference to the wiring that goes from the panel to the kitchen to bring the power. Okay. So that 20 amp circuit can be connected to one or more outlets. Okay? That's what I want to make sure that is clear. Now, let's go to the next point. Feeder load for each circuit computed at 1500 watts. Okay? The feeder load for each circuit is computed at 1500 watts. What's the meaning of that? What do you think? Feeder load for each circuit have to be computed at 1500 watts. feeder load. What is the feeder load? Vergara?
People in this.
Feeder load. Feeder load for each circuit is computed at 1500 watts. Feeder load. What is feeder load? Now, if we don't know what feeder load is, where can we find this in the NEC? Jacob? Can I find in the NEC what a feeder load is? Guillermo, ¿tú sabes lo que es un feeder load? Either my mic is out or everybody is sleeping. Let me see.
My mic is coming from the. It's just power coming from like your power provider.
Feeder load. What is the feeder load? Where would I find that in the NEC? The meaning of feeder load. Do you remember what chapter was about definitions? Does the 100 remind you of anything?
It was either the last one or the first one.
The last, first one, right? So we're looking for feeder load.
I'll be right back. I'm gonna go to the assignment. Resistance.
Oh, it's cutting off. There's your voice. Why is that? You minimize open. Mr. Guillermo is open. Let's close it. Okay, Vergara, go ahead, please.
I'll be right back. I'm gonna go to the assignment that we have.
Oh, that you're doing it?
Yeah, I'm gonna go do it. So.
Okay, go ahead.
I'm gonna log out and then log back in. Once I'm done.
Do you need to log out?
Yeah, because you need to turn off the breaker panel.
Oh, no. If you take a look at the, let me see. Yes, that's correct. Okay. All right.
Okay, it won't take me long. Okay, I'll be back.
But you have the computer has battery, right? Yeah, but your internet will be killed too. Okay.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay.
Okay. Jacob, are you there? Hello, Mr. Jacob, Mr. Reynolds. Mr. Harani? Harani, are you there? Harani, are you there?
Yeah.
Okay. Can you please tell me what is a feeder load?
Or if you have no idea.
Or if you have no idea, where can you find that in the NEC?
I don't have my book. It's in my car.
Okay. So, feeder load. Okay. Feeder load. In what other place can you find that information? Google it. See what it tells you.
Okay.
Feeder load. Guillermo, busca qué significa feeder load. ¿Oíste, Guillermo? ¿Estás ahí?
Sí, sí, estoy aquí, estoy aquí.
Busca feeder load.
Feeder load, ok. Bien.
Feeder load. Feeder load. What is the feeder? Se llama feeder. Búscalo ahí. Sí, load feeder. Load. Loads, 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 feeder, loads, feeder, load feeder calculation. Okay, 222. 220. Okay. Twenty-two. Farm loads. 220. Loads feeder. The case of the farm. The 15. Dos. Ah. Lo quise dos. Ah. Feeders. This article covers installation requirements, overcurrent protection, minimum size, and opacity of conductors for feeders. Okay. Feeders. Exception. Feeders for electrolytic cells are covered in 668. Feeder conductor shall have an opacity wires no less than the required supply load to be calculated. Feeder conductor. Feeder conductor. What is a feeder? Look at this. Feeder. All circuit conductors between the service equipment, the source of a separately derived system, or other power supply source, and the final branch circuit overcurrent device. Okay. ¿Qué quiere decir eso? Anani, Jacob, Guillermo.
Ajá, sí.
El feeder dice.
Okay.
All circuit conductors. ¿Entiendes eso? Dime qué palabra.
Sí, sí. Sí, todos los circuitos.
All circuit conductors between the service equipment, comma,
ajá,
the source of a separately derived system or other power supply source and the final branch circuit overcurrent device. Ese es el cable que va de dónde a dónde.
Ese cable que va desde la caja a cada uno de los, no, de los circuitos, vamos
ese,
a decir.
Ese es el branch circuit.
Mm.
El feeder es el que alimenta el que alimenta eso.
Okay. Ajá, cada uno de los circuitos, diría yo.
Fíjate. Son los conductores,
ajá,
entre
ajá,
el equipo de service. ¿Qué cosa es el service equipment?
Service, ese es, o sea, el cable que va desde la caja a, de afuera a la caja, vamos a decir.
Ajá. Entonces, service equipment es a donde llega el reloj o lo que sea, ¿no?
Exactamente, la microondas, etcétera.
Coma, y clarifica, the source of a separately derived system.
Ajá.
O como el cable que viene de un generador también para la entrada de la casa. Okay.
Ajá.
Or other power supply source and the final branch circuit overcurrent device. Mm-hmm. Cualquier otra unidad de potencia.
Ajá.
Y el branch circuit.
Ajá.
Branch circuit overcurrent device.
Exacto.
Y el alambre que va hasta donde empieza el branch circuit y donde está el fusible.
Mm-hmm.
¿Okay? Eso es el feeder. ¿Okay? Entonces, feeder load for each circuit is computed at what?
Mm-hmm.
At 1500 watt. So, the load, that's the meaning, that's the actual meaning, the load. The feeder load es, the feeder load es que lo que se requiere de la potencia de entrada.
Okay? Mm-hmm. Exacto.
Para cada circuito,
mm-hmm,
okay, se computa, se calcula a 1500 volt ampere.
Mm-hmm.
Ok. 1500 volt ampere. ¿Estamos claros?
Sí, sí.
No circuit may serve more than one kitchen. Tú puedes tener tres cocinas en tu casa. Ok.
Sí.
No, ¿y de? No puedes tener más de dos cocinas en tu casa. No puedes tener más de una cocina en tu casa. Ya eso sería un como una comuna. De hecho, la gente que tiene en casa, oye lo que te digo.
Ajá.
Que tienen casa y alquilan cosas por ahí, que tienen hornillas y tienen cosas de esas.
Ajá.
Cuando van a pasar los inspectores, mandan a su carpintero y tal, esconden la cocina, esconden todo, pasan al inspector, todo bien. Bueno, ¿comprende? Porque no puede tener, sí, más de una, sí, cocina.
Una sola cocina.
Una sola cocina. ¿Ok?
Ok. Sí,
entonces,
sí.
Entonces, ninguno de esos circuitos puede alimentar a más de una cocina.
Okay. Sí, ya entiendo.
Listo.
Sí,
¿qué,
sí,
te parece esto así de presentar en medio del PowerPoint? A mí me encanta esto.
Sí, sí.
Está chulísimo, ¿verdad? Como la noticia.
Sí. Y la noticia tan fuerte ahora.
Mira, muchachos, sí, no quiero ni verla.
Este no está fácil.
Entonces vamos a ver. Vamos a ver el siguiente slide. El siguiente slide es... A ver, ¿qué tenemos aquí? ¿Qué tenemos aquí, don Guillermo?
Sí.
Aquí dice, piensa acerca de esto. El cuarto de lavado. Y pregunta, ¿el Código Nacional de Electricidad requiere específicamente un circuito, un branch circuit, para la lavadora?
Sí, debe tener un circuito solamente para eso, para el área de lavado, vamos a decir, lavadora y secadora.
¿Por qué?
Porque eso tiene un alto consumo. Normalmente la secadora tiene 220. Eso hay que tener un circuito aparte.
Y yo no puedo tener más. Un branch circuit, ok. Yo puedo tener más de dos lavadoras, ¿no?
Bueno,
yo lo que
no
quiero,
sé.
Yo lo que quiero es que quede claro.
Ajá.
Que no se confundan el branch circuit con un outlet.
Uh-huh.
Ok.
Yo me imagino que nada más es una lavadora y una secadora.
No, pero eso no es lo que quiere decir.
Uh-huh.
Brand circuit es un brand circuit, un cable que va desde el fusible hasta el
conector vamos a decir, de la lavadora.
No, el conector hasta el cuarto.
Ajá.
Y en ese exacto. Cuarto se pueden conectar varias lavadoras.
Esa es así como el área de lavado.
Exacto.
Depende.
Entonces vamos sí. A ver qué dice el NEC.
Sí.
Ok.
Ajá.
No dice. A ver. Loads for household cooking appliances are calculated using the demand factor steering table 2055. And nodes to 2055. The most important single piece of information required to set the circuit is the equipment plate rating. Okay.
Sí.
Y esto iba con esto. Okay. Y este. One cooktop and one oven. ¿Qué nota de la tabla 220-55 se refiere a esta instalación? Ok, vamos a verlo. En la tabla 220-55. 220-55. ¿Dónde podría estar esa tabla? ¿Dónde me dice que puede estar esa tabla? Doscientos veinte, cincuenta y cinco. A ver, aquí dice la tabla 220-55. Jacob, Alani. Te lo seguimos en español contigo.
Sí.
La tabla 220-55. El demand factor and loads for household electric ranges. ¿Ok? Eso te da el demand factor para las cargas de las cocinas eléctricas. ¿Ok? los hornos empotrados, los counter-mounted cooking units, and other household cooking appliances sobre 1 3/4 kilovatios del rating. O sea, es para todo eso. La columna C será usada para todos los casos que sea permitido en la nota 3. ¿Ok? Entonces, one cooktop and one oven. ¿Ok? Cooktop se refiere al counter-mounted cooking. Eso es lo que es un cooktop. ¿Ok?
Sí.
Which note under NC se refiere a la nota de abajo. ¿Qué nota de esta se refiere a esta instalación? Cook note and note oven. Vamos a ver. Over 1200, 12 kilowatts ranges, no. Over 8 3/4 kilowatts ranges, tampoco. Over 1 3/4 kilowatts through 8, give the method provided in C, shall be permissible by the nameplate in C. Column C to be used in all cases except as permitted in note. Okay. Branch circuit load shall permit to calculate branch circuit for one range according to table. Limit the branch circuit load for a wall mounted en la nota 4. Okay. ¿Por qué? Porque dice branch circuit load. It shall be permitted to calculate, será permitido calcular the branch circuit load, la carga de. ¿Cómo se dice branch circuit en español?
Brown circuit.
El cable que va desde el breaker al allí a la cocina, por ejemplo.
O sea, si el brown circuit es el circuito marrón, no sé.
¿En tu país le dicen circuito marrón?
No, pero digo yo que ese más o menos así que yo lo traduzco. El inglés ahí.
No lo traduzca. ¿Cómo le llaman en español en tu país?
Te dice el cableado que va desde la caja a vamos a decir, a la cocina.
Exacto.
No, eso es, no sé, le dicen, porque ese ya, realmente.
No lo conozco.
Lo que le dicen, no sé cómo.
Bueno, es la nota 4, ¿ok? Porque hace referencia a eso del que voltó. Seguimos hacia adelante.
Sí.
Esto está muy interesante, este chapter, para que tú lo sepas.
Sí.
Water heater load. For fixed storage, water heaters with the storage capacity 120 gallons or less, the branch circuit to be rated at no less than 125% the nameplate rating of the water heater. ¿Por qué? Porque se considera una carga continua. ¿Vale?
Sí.
Electric heating loads. Vamos a ver. Los branch circuits pueden suplir cualquier tamaño de equipo que sean para calentar, como de calefacción, ¿no? Si dos o más enchufes son provistos, el tamaño del branch circuit está limitado a 15, 20, 25 o 30. Los servicios fuera, servicio eléctrico fuera, se puede designar a suplir ambos, los circuitos de la luz y otros circuitos. ¿Ok? A ver qué tenemos aquí. Este es, fíjate.
Sí.
Este es el nameplate de un aire acondicionado. ¿Vale?
Ajá.
¿Y qué dice ahí? Déjame ver si, porque eso yo lo veo un poco borroso, si en la presentación está así también. Espera un momento. Esta es la primera. La primera. Esta es la segunda, yo creo. A ver. ¿Tú ves esto que tengo en la pantalla, no?
No lo estoy viendo, no.
Se ve más claro. Es que como pierde al pasar por la cámara, parece que pierde resolución. Yo creo que eso tiene que ver con el programa. Ah, ya yo sé.
Porque yo no lo veo a usted aquí en la
no,
pantalla.
No, espérate. Todavía. Ahora.
A mí me dio tanto trabajo entrar hoy. Yo me pasé la mañana entera en eso.
¿Pero por qué?
No sé, la computadora le pasó lo mismo que le pasó aquella vez, que duró una hora reiniciándose.
Ah, coño, pues entonces tú sabes lo que fue.
Sí, entonces me tuve que esperar ahí ella y que ella terminara.
Claro, claro. Pues mira, eso es importante tenerlo claro, ¿eh?
Sí.
Vamos a ver aquí, cámaras, preferencias, general. Meeting room, phone number, calendario, notificación, video system. No. Aquí yo pensaba que era lo de la resolución. La resolución va a ser en otro sitio. La resolución va a ser en otro sitio.
Sí. Como
por ejemplo aquí, cuando tú le pones, a ver, participante, meeting, audio, speaker y cámara. Había una parte que decía que si querías una resolución mayor o peor. Cámara. Pero yo creo que eso es por la cámara que estoy usando, ¿sabes? Yo creo que cuando yo le pongo otra cámara que tengo ahí, se va a ver mejor. En vale, debería tirar una foto para asegurarme cómo es que se ve eso. ¿Ve? Ahí se ve. No, se ve igual, se ve bien. ¿Oíste? Yo lo veo bien.
¿Y usted lo está viendo por dónde? Por...
No, con la presentación. Ahora me ves, ¿no?
No, yo no la veo, la presentación. No la veo aquí.
¿Por qué no me ves?
No sé.
Si estamos lo mismo que estábamos haciendo antes. En la cámara.
No sé si es que yo tengo apagado algo, no sé.
No, pero tú no me estabas mirando antes.
No, yo nunca lo veo.
Ah, ¿nunca me viste?
No, yo solamente lo oigo.
Vamos a ver.
No sé si es que yo me falta darle a... Hay un punto que está...
Dime qué tienes en la pantalla.
No, ahora mismo lo que tengo en la pantalla es un calling. Donde está en un número de teléfono, un código de acceso.
Eso, cierra eso.
Ajá. ¿Y por dónde yo lo puedo ver? Porque no quisiera puncharla mucho, no vaya a hacer cosas que se... Desconecta.
No, lo mete otro, lo pones, conectas otra vez.
Déjame ver.
Siempre cuando uno apague la computadora, a Harani le pasaba lo mismo.
Porque yo sí lo oigo bien, pero no veo más nada.
En lo que tú miras eso, voy a ver si me pongo una chaqueta, a ver cómo me veo aquí con chaqueta.
Sí, sí, déjame ver. Vamos a ver si... Yo no me veo la foto suya.
Esto es otra cosa. Hay que andar encorbatado. ¿No me ves todavía?
No, no, es que no sé por dónde que se puede.
Vamos a ver. A ver, pero tú...
Ya más veo, nada más veo la foto suya. Una foto.
Ah, tienes que entrar a la... Porque tú no has entrado a la... Espérate.
¿Y los muchachos también se ven, los otros?
Ellos me veían a mí.
Oh. No, ya nada más lo oigo.
¿Tú no me ves? Ahora yo te veo en pantalla completa.
Sí, pero no. No lo veo para atrás.
¿No me ves?
No, solamente la foto, como digo.
Tiene una foto de la pantalla y pone la cámara que yo te veo a ti a pantalla completa aquí, fíjate.
Déjame tirar una foto.
¿Y abajo qué es lo que tienes?
Abajo, yo le voy a decir dónde que yo estoy. Le voy a tirar una foto y se la voy a enviar.
Oye, tiro una foto a todos. Que coja la pantalla
entera. Ahí le voy a mandar una foto por WhatsApp.
No, no, sí, ponla delante de la cámara.
Ah, bueno, perfecto.
A ver si se ve.
Sí, déjeme ponérsela.
Quizás no se vea muy bien. Mándamelo por WhatsApp para ver los detalles. Sí, eso, eso es lo que es.
Okay.
Cuando está eso, tú tienes que... Guillermo Peña.
Vamos a ver.
Escribiste hola en un chat ahí, ¿lo viste?
Sí, ahí dice hola, sí.
Ajá, y si yo cierro aquí, ¿se cierra el chat?
No, está igual. Dice hola y está la foto suya.
Ok.
Déjame enviarle el...
Y yo pregunto una hora, ¿y ahora me ves?
No, no.
Tampoco.
No lo veo, no.
Wow. ¿Me enviaste ya?
Sí, ahí la envié.
¿Cómo no es posible que tú no me veas? A mí no entiendo.
Ah, yo estoy en esa posición, pero no veo dónde yo le pueda dar para que salga la
clara. Espera un momentico.
¿Hola?
Sí, sí. Se oye.
¿De dónde
te llamas? ¿A la casa? Sí, porque se ve claro, pero no.
Los hospitales deben tener más trabajo que antes. Ya. Sí, pero ella no tenía hospitales de cliente también.
Disculpa, no sabía, sabía.
See you Monday, Professor. I have to go.
You have to go, but you were gone for a long time already.
Yeah, my bad. I have to go get this real quick. But...
Okay,
all
take
right.
It easy. Take it easy.
All right. See
bye.
You guys Monday.
Thank you. Bye. Guillermo.
Sí.
Jalani.
Ya se fue, Jalani.
Se fue. Vamos a ver. A ver, ¿me enviaste por WhatsApp?
Sí, le envié por WhatsApp, al correo suyo.
Vamos a ver, ¿no? ¿Al correo o al WhatsApp?
Digo, al WhatsApp.
A ver, ¿dónde tienes que apretar ahí para...? Mira. Chat with all. Message. El botoncito de arriba de la izquierda.
Ajá, sí.
Pincha el rojo, a ver qué cosa es eso.
Ajá, ahora. Este me dice que es récord. Como grabar, para grabar.
Ah, que están grabando, no, que se está grabando. Y pincha el otro, pone el ratón arriba del otro.
Dice Ciru personal, Hope, no, Ciru no, Río. No. Ajá.
Ajá.
Dice,
a ver, es un punto blanco con una cosita redonda, lo que yo veo ahí.
Sí, eso, a ese le di.
¿Y qué
ahí aparece un cuadrito que aparece la foto suya. Dice agenda, meeting link, meeting número, web support, about her and send prof report. Eso es lo que dice. Le tiro una foto para que lo vea.
Aprieta donde dice Zero Host.
Ah.
A ver.
No,
y abajo, no, eso no. Abajo hay una cosa redonda ahí. Apriétalo ahí a ver qué cosa hay. Abajo de todo hay un círculo.
Abajo de todo lo de ahí en el cuadrito.
Donde dice Ciro Ríos Host, abajo, en azul. No hay un circulito. Está el icono de un correo, un folder, lo de Google, a la izquierda otra cosita, un cuadrito. Y después
ese cuadrito es. Okay, el cuadrito que dice Ciro Ríos Host. Le voy a dar ahí. No hace nada.
Mira, vamos a hacer una cosa.
Ajá.
Ahí donde dice chat a la derecha, cierra eso.
Chat, ok.
La X. Cierra.
Sí, ya. Sí, ya lo cerré ahí.
¿Qué ves?
No, ahora nada más está todo igual, menos que nota eso.
Meeting in progress. ¿Y abajo tú le diste a algún sitio?
Sí, yo le he dado a todo los botones, no me aparece nada. Ya yo lo he intentado con todo.
¿Pero cómo va a ser esto posible, chico? A ver.
Nada más me aparece la foto.
A ver, cierra todas las ventanas que tienes ahí. A ver, y si se corta, me llama otra vez, te conecta otra vez a Webex.
Sí. Ya, ahí la cerré, ¿verdad? Sí, hello.
¿Hola?
Sí. Yo cerré la ventana, estoy en Google ahora.
Ok.
Pero no me aparece más nada.
¿No te aparece más nada?
Sí, no. No hay ningún botón que me diga para ver video ni nada.
¿Tú ves algún icono que dice arriba, que dice Ciro Ríos, Guillermo o algo?
Arriba dice Ciro Ríos Host. Host.
¿Y si pone el ratón hacia la derecha?
No aparece más nada. Solamente eso.
¿No aparece más nada?
No.
¿Dónde dice Ciro? Ciro Ríos Host. Ya lo vi ya.
Sí, arriba.
¿Y si cierra esa ventana, qué pasa?
No, si la cierro se va y ya.
No, cierralo. Si se va, te conectas otra vez.
O sea, dándole a la X, ¿qué te dice?
Dándole a la X, sí.
Se va y todo.
A la X de la derecha, cierra.
Dice, leave Sirio, salí del sitio. Esta página va a crear adicional diálogo. Bueno, se va a salir si le doy ahí.
Bueno, sale y entra otra vez a ver qué carajo que está pasando aquí.
Ok, vamos a darle la X.
¿Sigues ahí?
Sí, déjame ver que no se ha ido nada. No.
Es la X de la derecha.
Sí, ya.
¿Sigues ahí todavía? Espérate. ¿Tú me oyes? Guillermo, hola.
Okay. No.
¿Qué pasó? Déjeme ver. ¿Qué pasó? ¿Me ves? ¿Me ves? Vamos a ver, si te desconecta, conecta otra vez. Entra otra vez. A ver, Guillermo, te estoy escribiendo aquí.
Hello?
Hola?
I finished the assignment.
Okay, let me ask you, can you see my screen?
Yep.
Okay, because Guillermo is having a... He can only see my picture in the center. Do you have any idea what needs to click in?
Your picture in the center?
Right.
What do you mean?
He cannot see my... He cannot see my video. He can see just the picture. You know what he can see? He sees something like this. Look. When I go like this, let me see. When I close. No. Cancel. When I go like this. Okay, when I turn off the camera, look, when I turn off the camera, and that's what it looks
like. You can only see, okay.
This is what you're seeing right now.
Okay. Okay.
Like if my camera was not getting to him, but it gets to all of you. So I don't understand. So if I turn on my camera now, maybe he should try to turn, no, I can't see him, that's the thing.
If he can only see your picture,
if he can click, yeah, he can.
So I think.
Okay,
I
let me ask you something.
I think.
Let me ask you something. What do you see right now?
I think it could be his internet.
Oh, his internet, right? Let me ask you. Yeah. What do you see right now?
Your picture.
You see my picture in the center, right? My picture
it's
in the center.
It's either he has to re-log.
Well,
like
He logged out and he's trying to log back in now.
Or it might be his internet.
That is slow, right?
Yeah, because when his internet is slow, like if he has anything else like downloading while he's in this meeting, your webcam won't appear for him because it's
too much bandwidth.
Yeah.
I see. Let me tell him so.
He's in now.
He came back in? I'm talking to him in the
He came back and he's right here.
Yeah, I see him. But I'm trying to tell him what you told me. Can you talk to him? I mean, by voice?
I mean, you can talk to him.
No, I can talk to him.
But he can. I'm pretty sure he can hear you.
Guillermo, ¿me oyes?
Entré aquí, sí, lo estoy oyendo.
Y
pero nada, no importa, yo lo...
Vamos a ver. Es que tú tienes cámara. Es que tú tienes cámara y te veo perfectamente.
Sí. Ya la computadora tiene su cámara. Sí, pero está bien. Yo lo oigo bien aquí.
No contra, pero es que el objetivo de esto es que veas el PowerPoint.
Okay.
Porque mira, si yo comparto mi screen, okay. Ahora que tú ves.
Veo un cuadrito a la derecha.
Que yo estoy ahí, ¿no?
Ajá, estamos todos y ustedes arriba.
Ahora sí me ves.
Bueno, la foto nada más, en el cuadrito.
Ah, pues te estoy diciendo, cuando yo te digo que si me ves, me refiero al video. El video no lo ves tampoco.
No, el video no lo estoy viendo. Déjame ver, aquí dice que Beam View Screen. Pero yo antes lo veía, ayer lo vi en PowerPoint, hoy no sé qué.
Apaga.
Ayer yo lo estaba viendo.
No, pero es que hoy está haciendo una cosa diferente, pero todos me ven. Apaga la computadora, sí. Y enciéndela otra vez.
Yo creo ahora sí. Entró el PowerPoint suyo. Ahora sí. ¿Qué fue lo que usted le hizo?
No, pero yo lo que quiero es... Vamos a ver. Ahora se ve muy pequeño.
¿No? Pero yo estoy viendo ya el PowerPoint suyo. Lo estoy viendo.
Pero fíjate. Ahora yo le quito compartir. ¿Ya no me ves?
Ya. Y ahora no lo veo.
¿No ves? Vergara, you can see my PowerPoint, right?
Yep. It's a little bit blurry, but I can see it.
Yeah, okay. So Guillermo, ahora yo tengo el PowerPoint en la pantalla completa. Y Vergara lo ve, pero tú no. ¿Por qué no lo ves?
No, habría que ver qué.
Apaga la computadora y arráncalo otra vez.
Déjeme ver.
Pero fíjate, no le digas restart, dile apagar.
Ajá.
Para que te cuando el arranque te empiece de cero.
Ah, ok.
Ok.
Sí, déjeme.
Déjeme dar una instrucción aquí a uno de por anoche que no puede entrar todavía. Qué cosa más grande.
Pero yo viendo la hora ya, profesor.
¿Qué hora es?
Ya tengo las 12 y 16.
Bueno. Pues nada.
Yo lo que voy a hacer.
Vamos sí, a dar para... por concluido aquí. Y cuando venga del trabajo, conéctate para ver si podemos solucionar eso. Porque es aquí tu computadora, no es aquí. A lo mejor necesitas algún flash, ¿cómo se llama esto?
¿Algún botón que yo no le he dado?
No, botón no. Una cosa que para hacer esto te hace falta un programa de flash, que tienes que actualizarlo o algo. Acuérdate que tu computadora se estaba actualizando.
Okay. Sí, sí.
Porque muchas veces se actualiza y cuando la arranca otra vez se siguen actualizando otras cosas.
Yo la voy a dejar, la voy a poner actualizada y la voy a dejar encendida para que se actualice todo el tiempo.
¿Todavía está actualizándose?
No, por si acaso.
No, te explico. Tú la actualizas, pones. Cuando la necesites otra vez, puedes estar actualizando otra porque requería esa actualización para hacer otra.
Ah, ok, ya entiendo. Sí.
Ok, pues vamos a dar esto por concluido hoy. Jacob, I think you have to leave. Guillermo, you have to go to work. Ezequiel, did you turn in your homework for today?
Yep.
Ok. Guillermo, ¿tú entregaste la tarea de hoy?
La tarea de hoy era la... No, esta no la he entregado, ¿no?
Bueno, pues eso es la asistencia, tienes que entregarla. Y ahora te vas a trabajar, imagínate nosotros jugando con la camarita.
Oh, Dios mío. Tiene que ser, ¿yo puedo hacerlo en la noche? ¿O tenía que ser ahora?
Debería de ser antes de que la clase termine. Pero, eso es un momento, eso apaga la corriente, mide entre neutral y eso en un enchufe y di, medía tanto. Y además, haz el vídeo y manda el vídeo más fácil. No tiene nada.
O sea, lo que yo tengo que hacer es apagar...
Quitar el breaker de tu casa.
Ajá, todo o solamente de un área.
Todo, para evitar problemas.
Ajá.
Entre el neutral y ¿cómo se llama? Neutral y ground, la resistencia. Ajá. Y mide la resistencia. Te dice, tantos ohmios, o 0.1, o 0, vale. Pues... Mire, profesor, yo lo que hice fue esto, 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 y eso fue lo que me dio. Gracias. Ya.
Ok. Entonces yo voy a ahora, lo que voy a hacer es que voy a bajar los braids, le mido la resistencia que hay entre el braid y...
Mándalo lo antes posible, porque ahorita el me está llamando y dice, ¿cómo va tu clase? ¿Qué pasó con Guillermo?
Déjeme ver, porque no he entendido la tarea. Excúseme, dígame otra vez.
A ver.
Tumbar el switch.
Apagas el main breaker.
Ajá.
Pones el multímetro en ohmios.
Ajá.
Mide la resistencia entre ground y neutral. ¿Sabe cuál es el ground?
Sí, la tierra y el neutro.
Exacto, pero en físicamente en el enchufe, ¿sabes cuál es?
Sí, sí.
La tierra es el del centro.
Sí, sí, la tierra es el blanco y el verde es el ground.
Pero olvídate de colores, ¿cómo vas a ver los colores si estás mirando el enchufe por fuera?
Ah, ok.
Es el redondo, donde entra lo redondo del enchufe.
Ajá, el redondito, sí.
Y el más grande de todo.
Ok.
¿Ok?
Sí, sí.
Dale, apúrate y mándamelo, gracias.
Ok, bien.
Bueno, hasta el lunes.
Bien, ok.
Ezequiel.
Uh-huh.
You starting your work, right?
Yep.
Okay. So let's conclude the class for now and I'll see you on Monday.
Okey-dokey.
Okay?
Okay.
Thank you. Bye bye.
Bye.
I'm going to get on board the rest of the guys that are not able to look into Canvas yet. Somebody will. No, lo voy a dejar ahí para ver si me conecto con el resto. Ay, Dios mío, a ver qué pasa con esta gente. No pare de grabar esto.